So this is as far as they'll be going. They say past this bridge is basically the Bloomfield track, which is four-wheel drive. This is the Lion's Den Hotel. This reminds me a lot of Daly Waters pub in Northern Territory. Looks like a python skins, as long as it's python and not a taipan. Just heading south now. We've just passed the Bob's Lookout I was at earlier. So after leaving Bloomfield, I made my way south. Stayed at the Mount Molloy rest area for a couple of nights. That was great, it's a big park. And head to Mareeba, where I visited to the Heritage Centre, Information Centre. up in the Tablelands, looking towards Mareeba. Quite a few fires over there. Hi, piggy. I'm not allowed to feed you. So we're at Granite Gorge, and this is a really nice camping section. I went and got a powered site, but if I stay another night, I think I'll come down here. And you can apparently swim in that. Yeah, this is a nice little place here. Not so many people here yet, but I found this place on Wikicamps as well. Makes you want to jump in. Oh, there's little rock wallabies down there. Be the exercise for the day. Put these little markers on there to find your way. An unusual pattern in the rock there. I'm not wearing my thongs. Fig tree. Coming up to some dinosaur footprints. They're meant to be the footprints. It sort of looks like some sort of foot with toes. Looks more human than anything. Oh yeah, there may be another one. Now this sign here says footprints. That looks a little bit dodgy. Oh, this looks a bit tight.
And that's Whale Rock at Granite Gorge. It reminds me of the creature from the Black Lagoon.
You'd swear they were tire tracks, but that's solid granite. After a few days up in the Tablelands, I made my way back to Cairns for a few days, down to Gordon Vale and to the Bibinda Boulders. So I'm at the Henry Ross Lookout in Cairns, what used to be a good lookout. For some reason these people always like to let the trees grow up where there's a lookout. Oh, that's a shame. Smithfield and Cairns Airport over there. We're just in Gordon Vale now. Oh, look, a sugar mill. What a surprise. And you have Walsh's Pyramid at the back here. Going through the streets of Gordon Vale. This is the Green Patch Rest Area at Gordon Vale. And this was the main road here. That bridge wasn't there. And I can remember they burnt the sugarcane just there. It was a great sight. It was right near sunset. It was brilliant. Just off to the Bibinda Boulders. Yeah, it's nice and cool in here. I haven't been here for so long. You just see the river there. A lot of trees are down. I wonder if it's all due to just wet season. And, well, when I say down, they've taken them away.
sort of.
Out of it. Yep, it looks like you can't go onto the boulders anymore. You may not be able to go on the boulders, but it's a fantastic walk. It's a really nice rainforest walk.
How
is it, okay? It's cold. So B25 from Charters Towers via Darwin, a raid on New Guinea, crashed into Mount Bartalfreya. These hills are usually covered in cloud, you don't normally get to see the top. So the sign says this Merrawinnie is the hometown of the triathlete Brad Bevan. Oh look, sugarcane. Gee, look at this for a campsite at Bramston Beach. Unpowered. I get to look out that in the morning. Wow.
Good morning from Brampton Beach. Well, this is a nice way to wake up. Sound of the waves here at Brampton Beach. So we'll leave the coast and head up into the Atherton Tablelands, and wow, rainforest, waterfalls. See you till the next episode in Into Oz. Thank you.